Hello everyone, and welcome to XCOM with Terry. This is replacing the Bard's Tale because, well, the Bard's Tale is over. So I figured we'll do something else that's fun and not chips, because I occasionally like to play something that's not chips. And XCOM has a special place in my heart, because as a younger person, I really, really, really liked the first XCOM game. I was playing that back, I think, on my 486 with 66 megahertz on turbo boost, so that was interesting. But yeah, this is not the original XCOM, this is the, well, re-release, you could say, and it has been ported to Android, which means I can play it on my phone, which is awesome. So today we are going to start a new game, and I haven't played this. I've played, well, XCOM, the original XCOM, many, many years ago. I've played tactical or SRPGs quite a bit. So I did do a little bit of reading just to, you know, get myself familiarized with the game mechanics and everything. So we'll take things as they come. But let's start a new single player game. We're going to start in normal difficulty. And I have looked, there are a couple of second wave options that I would like to have. So I would like to have randomized economy. I would have to like randomized soldiers, randomized stats increase, and randomized skills. Because otherwise, you kind of just get the normal stats that, like, every soldier has the same stats. And there's no point in me having all my characters have the same stats, really, right? Is there? So these are the options that I figured we're going to pick. So let's begin. Those who play with the devil's toys will be brought by degrees to wield his sword. Sounds good to me. Well, I can already see this going well. Something green and creepy fell from space, so everybody just congregate around it and touch it and take selfies for Twitch or Snapchat or whatever you want to use. TikTok. Yep, as predicted, that's going horribly wrong. And he got eaten by the green goo. Okay. So aliens are dropping green fog things on us. And by the looks of the rather deceased people on the bottom, yeah, that is not going well for us.
Hello, Commander. In light of the recent extraterrestrial incursion, this Council of Nations has convened to approve the activation of the XCOM project. You have been chosen to lead this initiative, to oversee our first and last line of defense. Your efforts will have considerable influence on this planet's future. We urge you to keep that in mind as you proceed. Good luck, Commander.
So, let me get this straight. Aliens have started dropping green goop, like green fog things from space. And people taking selfies for Snapchat or whatever the kids are using these days, TikTok potentially, have obviously approached the things and then got killed by them. And the response of the world is to put me in charge of the Men in Black, the XCOM squad. And everybody thinks that's a great idea. Okay then. So we are the first and last line of defense against whatever comes down from space. All right, so we can pick a base location. All right, then North America gives us better aircraft, which is understandable. Europe gives us better research. Asia gives us better manufacturing. South America, we have ways, gives us better interrogation skills. Okay, I see what you did there. And Africa gives us increased funding. I think we're going to stick with North America. All right, then. Because more planes, I mean, obviously, right? If aliens are coming from space, planes is something we want to have. So more planes is going to be good.
We're going to be putting down in Mexico for this mission. We've picked up a local broadcast indicating alien activity within a major metropolitan area. We should get down there and eliminate any hostiles.
All right, and we're getting dropped right into our first mission. So following the opening screen, we've got our squadron in a dropship and we'll be dropped into Mexico, apparently. So that down there is Mexico City. And we have to neutralize all hostile targets and locate and secure meld container canisters. I'm not sure what meld is quite yet, but presumably it's the stuff that the aliens have dropped from space, so we will probably better be careful about this. Alright then, there's our squad, and it looks like we've got four people in it. They seem to be wearing some form of body armor and probably have rifles of sorts. So if the original XCOM is any way to go by, our initial weapons and armor are completely garbage against aliens, but we're gonna have to do some research to develop better ones. Anyway, let's get going.
Strike One, this is Central. You are free to engage all hostile contacts in the AO. Don't take any chances.
All right, so if you are not completely familiar with this kind of game, this is a turn-based SRPG. So I've got my squadron of soldiers and we make our moves and then the aliens make their move. I have a map, I have an objective. Occasionally we have something like time limits. So right now my soldiers, I've got, they're all squaddies or like rookies, like beginners. Because of course, if you send somebody to be the first and last line of defense against the universe, you send them in with a squad of complete newbies, rather than with somebody who actually has some experience in shooting things. So all of my soldiers, and I've got Ms. Vos here, they're from all kinds of nations, by the way, have a grenade, they've got an assault rifle, and they've got a handgun of sorts. So I can change between weapons. I've got Sean, he sounds distinctly Irish. I've got Greg, who's Canadian. And I've got Yuzuki Takahashi, who is Japanese. But yeah, they're all the same loadout right now, so there's no distinction quite yet between them. We'll see that when we get back to it. Cover is a thing, usually in these games, so we do need, and we do need to be careful, we do need to spot the aliens. So in my first turn, I'm gonna start, because all my soldiers are the same, so I'm gonna start and actually move up here. And here you see the shield icons. So the half shield means it's a half cover, and the full shield means it's a full cover, which gives you a defense bonus, so you're more difficult to hit when you're in cover. You basically want to be in cover at all times. So we're going to move Takahashi up and take a look what's inside that Mexican diner over there.
I'm on the move.
Look sharp, enemies rolling
on Earth. We're witnessing something never before seen in recorded history.
Okay, so we've been spotted, and we've obviously spotted some aliens, and we can see them there. We see the chance of hitting them. Once they notice that we have, well, they've spotted us and we've spotted them, so they've gone into cover, which means they are obviously more difficult to hit as well. So I'm gonna start opening up, and these meld canisters, now I'm on a timer to actually get these things. So let's open up with Takahashi.
Nailed him.
And nice, she takes out...
Their weapons appear to self-destruct when the operator dies. We should look closely for any fragments that could be salvaged for our own development programs.
Okay, so Dr. Valen is our scientist, and she just told us that, well, the weapons disintegrate when the aliens die, which is a good way of, you know, preventing tech from getting into the hand of the enemy, but well done, Takahashi. So she's taken out the first sectoid, and now we're looking at angles. So there's two more of them sitting over next to the canister of goop. So it's not the goop canisters we actually need to pick up. So let's go to our next squaddy. So this is Miss Vos, and she has angles at the aliens, but the chance is very low, 20% to hit anything. So we definitely don't want to shoot right now. We want to move up. So I'm gonna go. Do I have full cover? I have half cover behind the car, or I could move up here. But I could have moved up here to the door, and I might have angled at that alien over there. But then I'm awfully exposed to these two guys who could outflank me. So maybe I'll take the right flank side here. I'm gonna move up to the car.
Okay.
And do I have better angles? 20%? No, still 20% hit. But can I get a grenade off? So grenades. I have one grenade. Yeah, I think I can get a grenade off over there. So since I don't have to collect that thing, throw your grenade and see if you can blow these two guys out of the water. Well, grenade out.
Batter up!
Commander, you may want to instruct your men to exercise restraint when using explosives. While certainly effective at killing aliens, they also destroy the artifacts we're hoping to recover from the bodies. Just something to consider.
The accent of Dr. Valen confuses me a little bit. She occasionally has an extremely strong German accent, but not always. So I'm going to classify her. I'm going to call her Dr. Valen and classify her as honorary German. All right, Canadian, you can move up here. You got full cover. And see if we can get angles at the other alien from here. And the chances are not great, but let's try. And we hit him!
Taken care of. Good work out there, Strike One.
If I may, Commander, the labs are on high alert. Teams are standing by for your orders. We can begin researching the newly recovered artifacts immediately.
So, excellent. We have killed four aliens, we have lost no operatives, and we've collected two meld canisters. So obviously these were all the aliens that were hanging around in Mexico at this particular site in Mexico City. So well done, everybody. Let's head home in our pretty dropship. And that's our home base. It's somewhere in the middle of nowhere, America.
Welcome to XCOM HQ, Commander. I'm Central Officer Bradford. My role in this project is twofold, providing tactical support for our field operations and keeping you briefed on the current situation. My efforts should allow you to focus on the bigger issues at hand. Speaking of which, we have a soldier waiting for a promotion in the barracks. I'll let you get to it.
Impressive work, Commander. Our soldiers have to be feeling good after a mission like that.
Commander, to the research labs. All right, so, and now we come into the class system, because when our soldiers are rookies, they basically are generic soldiers. They don't have a specific class yet. But now three of our soldiers, because they basically the ones who got killed, gain some XP and are being promoted to squaddy.
Commander, to the research labs.
Yeah, I'm getting to the research labs. Will you wait? Be patient. I'm explaining to the people how the class system works. What was I saying? Right, they've been promoted to squaddy and they get a class assigned. And there are four classes in the game. There is a support class, the Angel Wings there's a sniper class, and there's an assault class, and there's a heavy class. And then there's a couple more things that we get to later, but these are kind of the four base classes that your human soldiers are getting. So let's start with squaddy Vos.
Commander, to the research labs.
The assault class serves as our front line. They're the first ones into a fight and the last ones out.
And Iris here has been promoted, has been assigned the assault class. So you don't get to pick those, but she gets a skill, the run and gun skill, which which allows us to dash forward and then take a shot rather than just move and just move our normal points. So that's our first one, and we've got Takahashi.
Our snipers specialize in dealing massive amounts of damage from afar, but without sufficient training, they're vulnerable in close combat situations.
Commander, to the research lab.
Yes, we will get to the research lab. Will you stop? We'll get to the research lab. So we've got Takahashi here, and you also see that they have hit points, they have a defense value, and they've got an aim skill. So the higher the aim skill, well, the easier for them to hit something. Now, 64 isn't great, so we're going to have to see what other soldiers we have. Maybe recruit some more and get somebody with a better... Get somebody who can shoot at a barn from the inside and actually hit it to be our sniper. Next up, Squaddy Mitchell.
Just like it sounds, the support class provides that intangible edge our squads need. They make everyone around them better.
Commander, to the research labs.
Commander, to the research labs. So... He, our Canadian soldier here, has actually a very good aim with 81, but he's now a support class, which means he can do things like lay smokes and heal and stuff like that, depending on the skills that they're developing. And you kind of see it here on the left side. This goes all the way up to Colonel. So as they rank up, they get skills. Normally the skill trees are assigned per class, but in this case, I've got the randomized skills because, you know, it sounds more realistic. And we'll have to see how we can find skills that make up for interesting combinations. Now, he should have been a sniper. That would have been better. But we'll see about this. And Sean here hasn't killed anything. Vols has just blown everybody up with her grenade. So he didn't get any kills. And that's why he hasn't been promoted yet. Okay.
The recovered artifacts are being unloaded, and the research team is waiting your orders. We'll get started as soon as you give the order, Commander.
All right. Operation Rotting Shield has been a success, and we've got some research available. So let's do that. All right. Well, this is my base, by the way. It's underground, and It's full of little chambers, and I have to actually build it. Now, if I figure out how to get back into it, yes. Okay. So we'll figure out what all these rooms are. But right now, they want me to go to Mission Control. But there's nothing in Mission Control. I'm not sure why they wanted me to go there. Let's go to Research, because she keeps bothering me about the commander having to go to the Research Lab. So over to the Research Lab we go.
Hello, Commander. My name is Dr. Farlan. I oversee the research labs. This is where all of XCOM's research and development takes place. We have already begun analyzing the artifacts recovered from our first encounter with the aliens. Based on our preliminary findings, we believe we can use them to develop some new equipment for our soldiers. With your approval, we will begin research immediately.
So from the
commander to engineering.
Oh, now you want me to go to engineering. I'm in research where you wanted me to be, and you've been nagging me for the last 15 minutes, and now you want me to go to engineering. Excuse me while I finish up in research. So the aliens drop bits of tech, even though their guns self-destruct, it still leaves smoldering wreckage. And we seem to, our research team around Dr. Valen here seems to be able to do something with it. So let's start a new research project. And what can we research?
Commander to engineering.
Yes,
Commander to engineering.
No, I will not be going to engineering. We don't have enough weapon fragments to actually research those things, but we can research. Oh, we've got the corpses of the aliens. Okay, so these are useful as well. So we can look at xenobiology. We can look at these. We can't look at these because we don't have enough weapon material fragments because we grenaded these aliens. And we can look at meld recombination. Okay. So we can either research the canisters or we can research the corpses of the sectoids. Let's start with the sectoids because that sounds more interesting.
Commander, I realize our troops have to put their own survival first, but every alien we use explosives against is one less opportunity to recover new artifacts.
Yes, okay, I get you. So don't... note taken, don't blow up the aliens. All right then. Next up... I think it's actually it's been quite a long episode. So next up, we'll satisfy a robotic voice here who wants me to go to the engineering, and we're going to check out the next room, and then probably figure out how we're going to build up our base and how we are going to, well, you know, or do all other kinds of things like develop new weapons, hire new soldiers, and shoot down aliens, I guess. So. That was a very, very brief intro to XCOM. And I am looking forward to playing this series. So let me see what you think. And we'll be getting on with it.
Commander to engineering.
And yes, I will be going to engineering next episode. Thank you. That's all for today. Thanks, everybody. See ya. Bye-bye.